technology. We researched ideas on the computer and amazing things. We presented them to the team. Some of our ideas include self-cleaning toilets, which they especially like that idea.
Yuck!
Our dads really like the golf balls and sweat themselves out. That might actually even give them a chance.
Then the voting center. We had to vote for one of the ideas that we researched. It wasn't easy to just pick one. They all sounded cool. Sports safety equipment seems to be a favorite since most of us play sports, but we had to narrow the field down to one type of sports equipment since there are so many areas, like helmets, pads, mouth guards, and a cup. The girls really did.
So we had to do more research and look for problems with current sports equipment in areas where injuries were occurring. We found that each year more than 3.5 million sports-related injuries occurred in children under the age of 15. According to the American Academy of Orthopedic Surgeons. That definitely seemed like a problem, but we needed to narrow it down even more, which meant more research.
So we started talking about problems that we had with equipment. We talked about helmets were uncomfortable, didn't seem to fit our heads very well. We found out that 309,322 sports-related hip injuries were treated in U.S. hospital rooms in 2005, according to the U.S. Consumer Product Safety Commission. Definitely a problem. So we voted again and picked helmet safety as our research topic.
Helmet check.
Then we found more research that proved poor-fitting helmets were a problem. According to the Harvard Injury Prevention and Research Center, an ill-fitting helmet doubled the risk of a head injury. They also reported that boys will most likely have a head injury, and that almost 60% of children under 10 had a difference of 1.25 centimeters between the size of their head and the fit of their helmet. We did more research on how helmet parts work and how to use nanotechnology to improve a helmet. This time we emailed experts, and boy, did they send us some interesting information. One of our mentors, a chemist at a local college, sent us lots of information. And he also visited our school. He taught us about liquid armor, which is Kevlar that has been soaked in sheer thickening fluid. Cornstarch and water is this type of SDF that acts like liquid under normal conditions, but becomes liquid steel upon impact. Liquid armor would definitely provide the strength that our helmet needed, but we still need to find a material that would provide a better fit and comfort because if a helmet isn't comfortable, kids won't wear it. Next, we started thinking of materials that are soft and can mold to your body. That is when we started thinking about memory foam. It is used in slippers, pillows, and mattresses, so we thought, why not put it in the helmet? This soft, form-fitting substance would mold to the unique shape of every kid's head and make it better fitted. We found the type of memory foam that had nanosilver. At the nanoscale level, silver has antibacterial properties. We thought that would be a comfortable material to use and no more germs too. We had finally found our solution.
Shape of your head and provides better fit and comfort.